those are the guys who go, oh, this is too advanced for you. You don't understand this process. You don't value this ownership, and yet they're falling for fishing skills from 2006.
For real, it's like, hi, I'm a Nigerian prince. I want to send you NFTs, lol. But first, I need your NFTs.
And then, like I said, you got twice the amount. I can dupe your NFTs.
It's like, how dumb are you? And like, wasn't the whole point of crypto and NFTs that like you can even keep it on an offline paper wallet and whatnot, and it's super secure? Yeah. How do you get duped to this bad?
I think that's the funniest email I could ever receive, Kaya. Hello, I'm a Nigerian prince, and my funds are tied up in NFTs. Let me send you these great pictures of monkey skins.
I love these comments. It is nothing but scams. Literally nothing. Every fucking reply to anyone who's commenting. Okay, so I advise you to send direct support message for guidance at metamaskoi.desk@gmail. And then next comment. Reach out to MetaMask support at mail@metamaskhelpcenter.com. Write email to metamaskapp.desk@gmail. Your request has been received. Please send email to metamaskoi.desk@gmail. And just it goes on and on and on, and I guarantee they get plenty of people that bite on it. It's crazy. It's nothing but scams.
Scammers are literally the but they're the worst people in the world, but I feel no sympathy for these NFT people at all.
There's a lot to fucking crypto and NFTs, and yeah, you can make good money and all this shit that's happening, but something I've been thinking about a lot lately is how with all this stuff, if you went through a bank or like a stock exchange, you'd be protected. Like if something happened and they stole your shit, you could go to the bank and be like, hey, this illegal transaction happened, help me, or the fucking stock, or whatever, you know, most of the time. Whereas with crypto, it's on you, that if you're just dumb and something stupid happens, your money's just fucking gone. That's it. It's totally gone.
That is the benefit to having some kind of structure or organization.
I've just heard of the...
Somebody
in the chat, please paste the fucking rap video.
No, can you... What happened?
Yeah, what happened?
Dude, I don't even know. All I know is that apparently this lady, they stole... I don't even know if they stole the crypto, but apparently they were laundering millions and millions of dollars in crypto.
Billions.
And she has...
Billions.
Billions?
Ah! Yeah, initially 3.5 billion worth of crypto.
And she has the worst fucking rap videos, and apparently she's Turkish, which I wanted to find, but here's a small tangent. I fucking hate... How now on YouTube, you cannot just find the source for anything anymore. It's all reaction videos. Like, I'm scrolling literally 50 fucking things down. It's literally all just people pasting their faces on top of this rap video.
It's because she got banned, so she's not allowed to have the originals up anymore. So when they get posted, they get taken down. And it was on TikTok, too.
That's been a thing forever, anyway.
Yeah, I had that exact...
Big since 2010.
I had that exact same thing happen. I wanted to find the original for a apology video from a YouTuber, but she got banned, and the only thing I could find was my initial reaction to it on stream.
when we were talking about stuff today, the guy from the No Work subreddit, I had to search for 45 minutes to find the original video, because every other video was just, oh, the No Work subreddit guy did this embarrassing thing, I'll talk about it.
Yeah.
It's like, I want to watch the original. Fuck.
It's not their fault, though. The original just get taken down for some reason. Like, when they get taken down, and they can't get put back up, like, they automatically just get flagged and removed instantly, which is why you don't see a lot of, like, original re-uploads anymore. It's really frustrating.
That makes sense.
It is frustrating. But it's sometimes, even when there is a rule, like, somebody just pasted one that actually works, but it's like, it doesn't even show up in the fucking results for me until I scroll down 50 minutes. At least prioritize the original YouTube algorithm.
But how would it know
at least
what
put it on
the original
top.
Is if it's not... If the original's been removed, how would they know what a re-upload of the original is? Like, how would they know that the original content?
When a video gets removed, I'm pretty sure they make, like, some kind of flag in their system or something, because there has to be a system or some kind of automation in place. There really does, because when something's down, like, removed by YouTube, I almost never see it successfully re-uploaded for any length of time.
Huh. So even if it's re-uploaded, it just instantly gets removed from a different account.
I can't prove that, but I, like, the last couple times I've tried to find something like kind of old from someone that got banned or whatever, I just cannot find it anymore. Usually it used to be that tons of re-uploads, like when you post something it lasts forever no matter what.
Yeah.
But recently I have just not been able to find it at all in the most cases.
The internet is... it's getting frustrating.
Oh yeah, you're listening to a Razzlecon.
We must stop
so
bomb.
Cringe.
Yeah. Her, did you see her interview her own husband? She was trying to have a conversation with her husband, and I think the husband was like the main guy behind the hack. He is the most inhuman acting person I think I've ever seen. He was talking about a cat. So they had a cat, and he's like, I actually really like pets now. I was never someone who understood pets until I got a cat. And then he slowly starts patting the cat's head, and he just says, I recommend everyone think about a pet at some point.
Is he Mark Zuckerberg? Like, what the fuck?
Much worse. Much worse. He was significantly more robotic.
Okay, so can you explain, I assume it sounds like you've looked into this, what is the actual story?
So, it's still unclear exactly how involved they were, but there was a big exchange that got hacked many years ago. And at the time, it was worth like 62 million worth of Bitcoin they were able to get out from this hack, but of course it's exploded. That initial hack has now ballooned up to like 3.5 billion worth of Bitcoin, and they just haven't been able to actually use it. So, they haven't been able to launder much of it. And I think they actually found them through her TikTok graps. And they were able to connect her and her husband to the hack.
How? Did she just
I don't remember. I actually don't remember. It was something, I think someone in chat said it was something in a Google Doc, and I vaguely remember that too.
Oh! But yeah, I remember that too. Apparently they were keeping their secret passwords in a Google Doc that was accessible to everyone. Law enforcement just fucking seized the Google Doc.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense. But yeah, I know the TikTok account had a lot to do with it initially. But I also know of that 3.5 billion, they almost got none of it out. They weren't able to successfully launder like almost any of it.
That's fucking weird.
I don't, because they're so fucking dumb, it's unreal. I feel like it should have been super simple. They could have just done the NFT scam. Just buying and selling NFTs to themselves. It would have been significantly easier.
Or just convert it to like Monero on those exchanges and like small amounts at a time.
Yeah, there's so many sketchy cryptos they could have just like walked it through to clean it. It makes no sense how they weren't able to. They're just really stupid. I can't believe they actually were the ones that hack it, so I have to imagine they were just like the viewers holding it in the elevator.
Do you think the cartel is after them now?
I don't know, but I just can't imagine those two were actually the ones to do it. It had to be them just being mules.
So did the rap stuff come first, or was it after she got attention?
No, the rap stuff came first.
God damn. Well, Not a good week for crypto bros today.
No.
If we're gonna... go ahead, Jackson, if you have a topic.
I was just gonna say, is crypto going down then? Is it like plummeting at the moment?
That's a good question.
So it went down in a dip. Down. It went down in a dip following the economy going down, but now it's been holding at where it's at for a while.
Do you think we've seen the peak for crypto? As a whole?
I don't know, actually. I think it could go either way. It's really unpredictable. It's entirely a hype market. The crypto is nothing but a hype market, so there's a good chance that it could be following what it did around 2017, where people kind of forget about it and don't care, and then all of a sudden everyone's talking about it because it's getting so low. So we could have that happen again. But who knows? This could have also been with NFTs, it could be finally when people are going, fuck this, I don't want to deal with this shit anymore. You know, you never know.
It'll be, I don't see if it's still around in a couple of years.
I read an, I don't remember where this was, but I read something about 80% or, I don't know, like 80% of all NFTs are controlled by the same 10% of people, something like that. So it's not exactly like there's a lot of people buying into the hype of NFTs either.
It's definitely a bunch of money laundering and flipping from ultra rich people for sure.
So that's just the 1% of NFTs. That kind of mimics real life.
Well, that's how it started, isn't it? Isn't the very first NFT that was really sold a big art piece by a guy, and it was basically money laundering?
No, you're talking about people who made like 70 million dollars in art piece.
That was legitimate, or was that?
Yeah, I think that was like an order of NFT exchange actually.
That's what I'm talking about. The fact that it wasn't like an actual just, oh, I want an NFT, I'll buy it. No, he was this did happen. He wanted to promote his exchange, so he bought it as an NFT on his exchange.
Okay.
That's why that happened.
Oh. Yeah,
It's all been scummy from day one.
That was the first big NFT. But how would he... If that's the big first NFT, how would he buy it on an exchange? Why would an exchange exist at that point?
Because
he's been around for a long time.
Yeah. That was the first big money-making, like, notorious NFT. Yeah. Basically, imagine you're at an art gallery, and you're like, oh, that piece of art looks great. I can't wait to buy it through Art and Sons Traders, the art broker that I trust the most for this much money. Look at this big deal they're handling. Ha, ha, ha. And then that's what brings people to them. So if we want to expound a bit on the hard press to find content on the internet, that has been frustrating me immensely lately. I wanted to find this old series of Matrix parody videos from like 2003, and all of them have been scrubbed off the internet by copyright claims by Warner Brothers. And they're from fucking 2003, and the quality of the video is like 144p, and it's super framey, and they're just comedy dubs that I remember watching as a kid and loving, but they're gone, because fucking Warner Brothers scrubbed it. And that's happening to so much shit now. If you try to remember so much media from before, like, 2008, it's just off the internet, it's gone. It's not preserved anywhere, it fucking sucks.
Yeah, you know they say the internet is forever, but that's really not true 100% of the time. Like, sometimes something just gets lost because someone somewhere did not feel like archiving it enough.
Yeah. Or copyright claims are catching up because
torrents.
Like, old media used to use copyrighted music all the time. Think how many old YouTube videos you remember as a kid are gone now because they used a copyright song in the background. Charlie, think how many fucking MLG montages used, like, In the End by Linkin Park or something, and now they're just gone forever because of it. Fucking sucks.
It does suck. You know what sucks even more, though, is I didn't preserve any of my old videos. I really wish I did.
Aw.
Yeah, I regret
you
that so
yourself.
Often. I know. About once a year, probably than that, like once every 5 months, I'm like, fuck, I wish I had all my old montages.
What would you do with them if you did?
Did you put out like a big call to action recently, asking people to go find it for money?
Yeah, I mean, the bounty's still up. I would be paying like 20 grand to anyone that's able to recover them, but it's an impossible task because I would be the only one that could preserve them or bring them back. YouTube didn't archive any of them. It predates Google's acquisition of them. So there's 0% chance that they're anywhere.
That's
and
how
I already
desperate
asked.
You are, though. You set them an impossible task that you know can't be completed.
Right. What would you do if you had them all back in the day? No, go ahead.
If I had them all, I don't know. It's just something I'd like to see. Because, I mean, that was like 5 years of my life growing up. Like, I spent so much time on those things. It's just a nice thing to have.
It's nostalgic to go back and, like, people give me shit for, like, bit defense and stuff like that, but I still fondly go back and look at...
Well, to be fair, Jackson, you were plagiarizing with bit defense.
Jesus Christ, it was one picture. That was one picture. Bit defense is a real thing with a real, like...
With a real dark side of the
design. Jackson. So you can't steal people's art anymore.
The good old days when you could just scam people.
Jackson plays Dark Souls 2. He gets nostalgic. He's like, ah, memories. I remember when I made this.
This is my finest piece of art.
Well, Charlie's the sucker that pulled it.
Well, hey, it worked out for you. Look what you're doing now.
Good job.
Oh, yes.
yes, it is.
Shit, our Kaiba is just... It's 5 years from now, we're gonna be bummed out. Because Jackson and I, from time to time, are still like, kind of bummed we never archived that one deleted episode with that one guest. We don't have it anywhere. Because I don't think we ever bothered actually saving our files. We were all just ashamed of like, yeah.
Well, didn't he edit it? So we could ask him if he still got it.
Only his audio.
No, he edited the entire thing, didn't he?
No, it was just his audio
to make himself look more witty and attentive.
Oh, God.
Oh, fuck, I still can't believe that happened.
Man, I really wish I had all my old videos. I'm thinking about it again.
What if you message YouTube and ask them to go back through their server?
I tried. They don't have it. Like I said, it predates like the Google takeover and like the archiving of everything.
Did you email the people who used to own YouTube? Maybe they still have some hard drives lying around.
There was one glimmer of hope. There used to be an MIT group of students that archived every single video on YouTube up until like 2009, which would pretty much encompass that entire era that I'm looking for. But they disbanded and apparently don't do that anymore.
Surely that's
That's
a lot of effort to just set it on fire.
It was a student project, and I guess just the graduated and like he didn't want to keep paying to host it or something. I don't really remember
now. They're not hosting it though, they're just storing it on hard drive, it sounds like.
What now? Sounds like they were just renting like Amazon Web Space or some shit.
Didn't feel like paying anymore. It was called like YouTube Tomb or something from MIT. I don't remember now.
How would you feel about just reenacting the world's montages?
Oh, there's no getting those back, unfortunately. Oh, I couldn't even pretend. I was so good at the games back then too. I wouldn't be able to do it anymore.
No. Go into Gears of War, the first one. Get a private server and be like, okay, you stand there, and I'll headshot you, and then you run over and do this, and it'll be epic. We'll do it.
I'm surprised someone's not already tried, like, scamming you for all that money.
Just
a voice actor.
Yeah, no, someone had a really good scam. So when I first was talking about it, I mentioned one in particular, because I filmed, I recorded a buddy of mine's game on Halo 3. His name was Dark Venom. And I mentioned the song that was playing in the background, and I guess I must have mentioned the map at some point too, because